to the 90s, when we've helped transform this city into a major IT destination. And now we are back with a major infrastructural push to the city of Hyderabad to take it into the next league of the global city as dreamed by the current leadership in the Telangana government. So this project will really transform the city of Hyderabad and put it in the league of world cities, undoubtedly. It is a concept which has caught up very well in the major global economies, especially the urban economies, where you have sizable amount of densified development seamlessly integrated with a high-speed, high-quality mass transit system. So it's an integrated mass transit system with sizable amount of development oriented along the corridors. So the cities actually can continue to grow uninterrupted in a sustainable way. So this is the inspiring trend which we are trying to bring to Hyderabad through the TOD development integrated with the Hyderabad Metro Rail project. Just if you look at the perspective, all of us from Hyderabad will agree, the traffic congestion what we have today in Hyderabad, it's a major metropolis in the city, rapidly growing, close to about 1 crore of population. But the public transportation systems are inadequate or not very convenient for the public. The last mile connectivities are not there. There's sizable amount of dependence though on the private vehicles, which actually puts a lot of strain on the road. The road coverage is about 10%, quite low for a global city standard. And that actually pushes the average transit peaks speeds to about 12 kilometers, which is very low. Also, the pedestrian access is very minimized because of encroachments on the pavements. And all in all of this is leading to huge amount of congestion, air pollution, and a lot of inconvenience and hassle to the citizens. So what's the solution? Like I mentioned, I think the city, to be continuously growing in a sustainable way, it needs to get hooked on to a reliable mass transit system and have the development oriented in such a way that this can actually carry the development along at the transit nodes or along the corridor. Plus also we should encourage citizens to actually take up to pedestrianization or use of non-motorized transport to reduce the pollution levels. And Hyderabad Metro Rail actually encompasses all of these features to take Hyderabad move on a sustainable growth. Like has been mentioned, the overall development envisaged out of this transit-oriented development in the Hyderabad Metro Rail project is about 18.5 million square feet at Miyapur and Uppal. And these developments will be large integrated developments offering a plethora of options to the customers. And the balance 30% will be used for development of this transit-oriented development. And we bring in multiple asset classes offering the customers a wide choice of options. So we'll have developments for IT, IT-enabled services or any corporate office. We will offer solutions for a multi-cliented environment, or we can also design large customized independent built-to-suit facilities and give them the solution. We'll also cater to the hospitality industry in terms of hotels, service departments, branded residences. Healthcare, of course, will get sizably benefited by the Metro Rail, where we can actually have full-scale hospitals, boutique hospitals, polyclinics, all of this as part of the TOD. And of course, mixed-use developments in some smaller sites where all of these asset classes can be integrated into one single development. It actually brings in a significant value proposition to all the stakeholders. In terms of, if you look at the user perspective, it will become very easily accessible, which is hooked down to the footfalls in a retail store or a retail mall. Because of the integration with the Metro Rail, this actually will have a 15% to 20% increase in the footfalls. And that actually will benefit the retailers doing much larger business out of the retail facilities on TOD. In terms of office space, if you see today, the IT-enabled industry spends close to about 3,000 to 4,000 rupees per employee per month on the transportation cost, which is a significant cost element in that startup. By being on the Metro Rail, they will get a significant transportation cost arbitrage because the employees can start commuting through a reliable transport. And that actually optimizes the efficiency of the operations. Plus, they'll have certainty on time of travel. Today, one major point the disadvantage by going through a road travel is the uncertainty in the time. Depends on the traffic situation. You can reach a distance in different times at different points in time. But with metro, you actually will have certainty on time. So the employee logins can be certain. So that's another comfort factor for the office-based clients. In terms of healthcare and hospitality, if you have a A-grade state-of-the-art healthcare facility, the clientele actually probably gets restricted by a geographic spread, maybe 5-10 kilometers within the radius. But with metro, all those geographies will get wiped out. People actually can access a quality healthcare facility or a hospitality development from anywhere in the city within 30-35 minutes. For the state and society, of course, this actually brings in sizable amount of economic activity through the densified development. It will actually result in decongestion as also reduction in the carbon footprint. Major clusters of development, along with Raidurg near the high-tech city, where we actually will be developing a significantly value proposition development in terms of product. At these three locations, Miyapur, Raidurg and Uppal, will add up to about 80% of the overall development. And the balance 20% gets interspersed across various locations in the city in terms of different asset classes. Like, for example, you see there's a identification also. You have malls, you have mixed use, which are smaller formats. And you'll have integrated developments predominantly in the large developments. This development will get driven by the market in 10 years. That's if the optimistic guess in terms of, as Mr. Gadgil mentioned, we have commenced development on three sites, adding up to about 1.1 million square feet of development. These are some of the images of those developments which will come up. You must be seeing the construction happening on the sites. These will get commissioned starting March, April 2016. These will be designed for LEED compliance at different ratings. These buildings will be oriented to minimize heat gain. They'll have double insulated glazed facades, these developments. And considering this scale of development, the quality of development and the integration, we've had significant interest from the market, from various clients in retail, office space. Some of the names Mr. Gadgil mentioned, these are already tied up. We hope to actually wrap up the marketing for these ongoing developments before commissioning and have these fully occupied malls to be launched in 2016. Thank you.